So what is SQL? SQL stands for Structured Query Language. This language allows end users to extract the information themselves without using a system group for every little report. So it is different than the procedural languages like C, C++, and other object-oriented programming language. Or you can say any language that you use for designing a front-end tool. SQL is different than those languages. SQL language is supported by many different DBMS softwares like Oracle, DB2, MySQL Server, Fox Pro, and there are many more, right? Sybase. Nowadays, MongoDB, right? There are many more. So Oracle is one corporation or one company which provides this SQL software. So by which we can able to perform the queries. So in our practicals, we are going to use the Oracle Lite software to execute our queries. Oracle is able to answer the questions like humans. The keywords used in query to Oracle software are having the words like select, from, where, and order by. There are many keywords that we are going to use, but these are some frequently used keywords in every query. What is the name of tool of Oracle software? It is SQL Star Plus. Okay, and there is one more language it is supported by Oracle that is called as PLSQL. This we are going to use, PLSQL we are going to use to write the program, to write the script. There are more than one commands, then it is called a script. But we are going to use this SQL Start Plus to write single query at a time. So it executes one query at a time. So there is a difference that is given here. It is SQL Start Plus is a structured query language supported by Oracle Corporation. Through SQL Start Plus, we can store, retrieve, edit, enter, and run the SQL commands and PLSQL blocks also. Using SQL Start Plus, we can perform calculations, list column definitions for any table, and can also format our query result as per our need. Suppose if you want to generate a report, then according to the requirements of the report, we can easily pick the columns from different tables of the database. And that operation is called as joins in SQL. Okay. What we do in PLSQL? It is an extension of SQL language. PLSQL block can contain any number of SQL statements integrated with the flow of control statements. It means that what are the statements that we have studied in previous languages like C, C++, Java, conditional statements, if else, then switch case, while, do, for loop, right? So loop control statements, all that is also possible in PLSQL. What is PLSQL stands for? Procedural language for SQL. Thus, PLSQL combines the data manipulation power of SQL with data processing power of procedural languages. So it is a combo of procedural language and non-procedural language. What are the benefits of SQL? The first benefit is that it is a non-procedural language, and because of that, we do not have to write a large programs in this language, non-procedural language. I just have to tell the compiler what is required, and rest of the things is taken care by SQL compiler itself. I need to have to specify what, how to get that data. I will say that what data is required, but how to get the data is not specified. In that case also, SQL gives me the correct answer the way the other programming languages give me the answers. It is the common language for all relational databases. So if you study SQL commands in Oracle, that are same in all the other DBMS softwares. So there are no changes, or you can say hardly little bit changes in the syntax of writing any commands of SQL. It is portable. You can perform SQL commands on any machine. You can just save it into the notepad file and you just copy it, send it to another machine, and if you run the same commands, you'll get the same results. It's very simple language, and having simple commands for querying, inserting, deleting, and modifying the data of the database. SQL language has four different types of sub languages. Structured query language has four different types of languages. The first language is called data definition language. It is called as data definition language. The second category of language is called as data manipulation language. Third is TCL, that is called transaction control language. And fourth is DCL, which stands for data control language. If you see in all these languages, there are different statements, different commands into it. Every command performs different tasks. Right? In data definition language, we deal with only the structure of the table. We never deal with the data or the content of the database. This is very, very important, student. You should know the difference between DML and DDL. In DDL, what do? We perform create, alter, drop, and truncate commands. All these commands are related to the changing of the structure of the database or table. But we can't do any manipulation by using this command in the database. What do you mean by not doing any manipulation in the database is that you can add a new column to the existing table. You can drop the existing column of the table. You can add 4 or 5 extra columns that if you want into the table. You can alter the structure of the table. You can drop the column. You can alter any data type at any moment. You can perform deletion of all the records at once using truncate command. So this is possible because of DDL commands. So we have create, alter, drop, and truncate. Remember this thing, that these commands never deals with the content of the table. What do you mean by content of the table? Content means the records available inside the tables. If I say student is one table, then what is the content? Your data stored in the table is called content. So I cannot change the name of the student, which is already stored in the database, using these commands, create, alter, truncate, and drop. So for that work, there are different commands and different language in SQL. So we have another category of language called as data manipulation language. DML stands for data manipulation language, which has again four different types of commands here: insert, update, delete, and select. DML language actually deals with the content of the table, but it never deals with the structure of the table. It is exactly reverse now of data definition language. Here, DML language deals with the content of the table, but it does not deal with structure of the table. Just remember these commands, that is insert, update, delete, and select, which comes under DML. We'll see in details all these commands. Now we'll move to the third type of sub-language of SQL, that is TCL, transaction control language, which controls the transactions which are happening in the database. And there are two commands here, that is commit and rollback. We have two commands, that is commit and rollback. Commit is means do the transaction successfully. If this transaction is successfully executed, it shows that updation done by that particular transaction. Any updates done by the transaction is saved permanently in the database with the help of commit statement. And suppose you execute the transaction and you're not satisfied with the transaction, you want to cancel the transaction, you want to cancel the changes made by the transaction in the database, then we have another statement called as rollback. So rollback will going to cancel the changes made by the transaction. You can relate these two commands with do and undo commands that we have in Microsoft Word or any editor, text editor. Do means do the changes, and undo means cancel the changes that you have recently done in the database. Okay. Then we have fourth category of sub-language of SQL, is DCL, data control language. there are two more commands. One is grant, another is revoke. What is the use of grant command? Basically, data control language deals with the controlling of data which goes from one user to another user in the database. Grant is the command which is used to give the permissions on our own database to another user. You cannot give permissions on any other user's data to another user. Remember these words. You can give permissions on our own database, our own tables to another users, but you cannot give permission on somebody else's data to third user, right? Then the next command is revoke. Revoke command is exactly reverse of grant command. It is basically used to revoke the permission or get back the permissions given by the grant command. So it does exact opposite action of grant command. Is it okay, students? Have you understood what are different statements which comes under the four different types of languages comes under SQL?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm going to ask you some questions on this. SQL stands for, write down in the chat box. What is the full form of SQL? Okay, Neha has given the answer. Good. Many times you make the mistake in final exam, like when the exam happens in MCQ format. Structure worry language. Who has written this? There is one student who has written it as structured worry language. It is structured query language. Okay. Okay. It may be the effect of autocorrect option. It's okay. It's okay, Pratik. Now the next question to you. Which language deals with the structure of the table? Which SQL language deals with the structure of the table? It is DDL, right? DDL language, correct. What are the statements that you have in DDL? Yes, very good. One, two, that is truncate. One statement is missing, students. There are four statements. I think Badal Hoja has given the correct answer. There are four. Yes, Ashwin Kumar is right. Create, alter, truncate, and drop. Yes, you can add one more, that is rename. Rename is basically used to just rename the table name. We will see all this statement in detail. Before that, now tell me which language deals with the content of the table. Which language of SQL deals with the content of the table? It is DML. Very good, very good. What is the long form of DML? DML stands for, write down, next question to you. Excellent. It is data manipulation language. Right. The next one. Next question to you. What are different statements which comes under DML? What are different statements which comes under DML language? Nishank, move your mic. Hello. Okay, you have again four segments into DL, that is insert, update, delete, and select. Very good. Now the next question to you. It is correct, student. All of you are right. Which language of SQL deals with the transactions? Good. It is TCL language. What is the full form of TCL? It is transaction control language. Excellent. All of you are right, students. What are the statements which comes under TCL language? Different statements comes under TCL. There are two statements, right? That is commit and rollback. Next question to you. Which language deals with the data of the database? Authorization of database. Yes, correct. It is DCL, which stands for Data Control Language. Which are the statements which comes under DCL language? Different statement which comes under DCL language. They are grant and revoke. Then let's start with TDL. What is the use of create command? Create statement in DDL. It is used to create any object like table, you can say database, trigger, view in the SQL language. To create a table. Now the next command. Alter command is used to modify the structure of the table. What is the use of alter command? Alter schema or alter a table. Using alter table command, you can add a new column to the existing table, or you can delete the existing column from the table. You can also able to modify the data type of any column at any moment using alter table command. Then we have third command, that is drop. What is the use of drop command? Yes, it is basically used to delete the whole table. It is basically used to delete the whole table, or you can say Pratik is saying database, it is the whole table, right? Then there is one more command called as truncate command in DDL. It is used for okay, Bharat. Okay, good. let's see now in detail. We have seen create command. It is basically used for creating a table. Alter commands to modify the structure of the table. You can add a new column, you can drop existing column, or you can modify the data type of the column at any time. Drop command is used to drop the whole table. The drop command not only deletes data but also deletes the structure of the table. Truncate command deletes the content of the table, entire content, all the data gets lost, but it keeps the structure of the table as it is. It means that it makes your table empty and keeps the columns as it is, the structure as it is, for further insertion. What is the difference between drop and truncate, students? In DDL, there are two commands, drop and truncate. What is the difference between those commands?
Drop will delete structure also, but truncate will the structure of the table as it is.
Okay. Lalit, write your answer in the chat box. Shivani Agarwal, deletes drop table command, deletes the table, but truncate only deletes the data, not the table. Good. So basically, you understood what is truncate command and what is drop command. We'll see the effect of these commands in our practicals. We'll actually going to perform this operations. Theoretically, we are studying in this theory lecture, but in practice we are actually going to perform this, right? Then coming to the next category of statement, that is DML, it has three statements, four statements, that is insert, delete, update, and select. What is the use of insert command? It is basically used for inserting a new record into the database or in a table. Update command is used to update existing records. Suppose you have already inserted the student data, like there is a student, say Rahul, and by mistake whose name is entered as Ram, and I want to change that name from Ram to Rahul. Then for that, I am going to use update command. So update command is basically used for updating the existing data in the tables. Delete command is used to delete few records or all the records, depending upon the condition that you mention into the where clause. Select command is used to fetch the data from the tables and display it on the user screen. It is basically selecting the data from the tables and display it on a user screen. In transaction control segment, there are two segments, that is commit and rollback. Commit will do the changes made by the transaction into the database, whereas rollback will cancel those updates made by the unsuccessful transaction. Grant is used to grant a permission on one table owned by a user to another user. And revoke is exactly reverse of it. It is basically used to get back the permissions given by the grant command.